For last lecture, we have got the idea about the, perfectly elastic phenomenon, है ना? Have you completed that? Okay, I think v1 is equal to 2u2 minus u1 and v2 is equal to u2, है ना? And the target is at rest. V1 is equal to minus u1 and v2 is equal to 0. Hai na? Have you completed that? Okay. Now, that we have seen about the velocities. Hai na? Now, for this, for the ad hoc collision, we are having parallel unit also. Hai na? So, for kinetic energy, what we will get? That we have to see. So according to conservation of kinetic energy, we are having the formula half n1 u1 square plus half n2 u2 square is equal to half m1 v1 square plus half m2 v2 square. Out of that, I can say that, see, right now conservation of kinetic energy. So, last two lectures we have seen half m1 u1 square plus half m2 u2 square is equal to half m1 v1 square plus half m2 v2 square. Out of that one body, I told you, consider the body to be the projectile and one body to be the target. So, can I say that this is the kinetic energy of projectile arrays or no? Before collision. So, kinetic energy of projectile before collision. One. Then what will be the kinetic energy of projectile after collision? This will be there. Okay, kinetic energy of the projectile after collision. Why I am saying this? I will explain it. This will be the kinetic energy of projectile after. Suppose if I change in kinetic energy for the projectile, means what? Projectile will strike onto the target. Target means the projectile target like hit. So it may transfer its energy to the projectile arrays of, so projectile get target will get the energy from the projectile arrays of. But target ला कितनी मिळेल energy projectile कडून कसं काढायचं projectile कडे energy ती एवढी projectile was initially having this energy after collision it is having this energy so energy transfer from projectile to target how to calculate suppose at first say it was 100 units okay 100 joule it is having 80 joule so how much energy is transferred to the target 100 होती आता 80 झाली त्याने किती ट्रान्सफर केली 20 ट्रान्सफर केली ना म्हणजे काय केलं याला सपोज इफ आय कॉल्ड एज के आय अँड इज के एफ काइनेटिक एनर्जी इनिशियल अँड दिस इज काइनेटिक एनर्जी फायनल अँड चेंज इन काइनेटिक एनर्जी कशी करणार तुम्ही के आय मायनस के बाय एस ऑफ कारण त्याने दिलेली आहे अरे सो अँड इफ द टार्गेट इज गेटिंग द काइनेटिक एनर्जी व्हाट विल डू काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ टार्गेट के आय kinetic energy I initial final target ची वाढली suppose काय करणार तुम्ही k minus k so whatever the kinetic energy say for the projectile whatever will be the change in kinetic energy for the projectile will be there the same will be change in kinetic energy of the target अरे सो नो कडा आपण बघशी लास्ट लेक्चर ला बघितलं एकाची वेलोसिटी 0 झाली आणि एकाची तेवढीच झाली 1 ची 0 झाली सपोज आफ्टर रे आणि 2 ची 1 एवढी झाली म्हणजे u1 u2 u2 स्टेडी घेतलं सपोज म्हणजे u2 स्टेडी होता टार्गेट स्टेडी होता u1 हिट झाला u1 गॉट हिटेड ओके नाउ व्हाट हॅपन इन द स्पेशल केस व्हाट हॅपन द वेलोसिटी ऑफ 1 वॉज get transferred in as the velocity of 2 out of the दोन बॉल घेतलेले बॉल लावले 2 बॉल्स सो इफ यू सी m1 is equal to m2 ची केस काढून बघा मिळाली का m1 equal to m2 ओपन द केस ऑफ m1 is equal to m2 त्याच्यामध्ये आपण काय केलेलं v2 is equal to u1 and v1 is equal to 0 म्हणजे काय केलं त्याने complete transfer of energy was happened from the projectile to target array solve complete transfer of energy was happened from where projectile to target okay that was one case only case m1 is equal to m2 means what you have to keep in mind where baga need baga I will not give in written anything whatever is there I have given when two bodies of same mass moving at different velocities say when they collide what we can call it as a head on collision special case out of that one is not moving another is moving okay one body is at rest and another body is striking but kadhi both are having same masses in that case velocity of projectile gets transferred into target completely ata suppose प्रोजेक्टाइल ने कंप्लीट वेलोसिटी कोणाला दिली टार्गेटला दिली मग प्रोजेक्टाइल ची वेलोसिटी किती होणार 0 किंवा तुम्ही डायरेक्ट म्हणू शकता वेलोसिटी ऑफ द प्रोजेक्टाइल अँड टार्गेट आर इंटरचेंज इनिशियली किती होती u1 u2 किती होती 0 होती आता उलट होणार u1 कोणाला मिळणार v2 इज इक्वल टू u1 आणि v1 किती होणार u2 किती होती 0 तर ती कोणाला मिळणार गेटिंग माय पॉइंट आता असं समजत झालं ओके वी आर स्टडिंग फिजिक्स सो व्हाय दिस इज हॅपनिंग वी हॅव टू सी अरे सो बरोबर ना असं का झालं सांगा ऑफकोर्स प्रोजेक्टाइलने काय केलं त्याची एनर्जी आता एनर्जी कुठली असणार प्रोजेक्टाइलला इट इज मूव्हिंग विथ वेलोसिटी व्ही सो व्हिच टाइप ऑफ एनर्जी विल बी देअर विथ प्रोजेक्टाइल काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफकोर्स तो काय करणार आपली काइनेटिक एनर्जी कोणाला देणार टार्गेटला देणार आणि टार्गेट आपली काइनेटिक एनर्जी प्रोजेक्टाइलला देणार टार्गेट स्टडी होतं त्याने किती काइनेटिक एनर्जी किती असणार ऑफकोर्स 0 गेटिंग अ पॉइंट मग या केसमध्ये काय झालं काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ द प्रोजेक्टाइल हॅज कम्प्लिटली ट्रान्सफर्ड to the target, yes or no? That is a special case, m1 is equal to m2. But is it the case always m1 will be equal to m2? No. Sometimes m1 will be very greater than m2. Sometimes m1 will be very less than m2. Getting my point? So there will be some calculation while doing this all with calculation. So that calculation will do. Is that clear to you? Shall we do that? So what I can say that I will call this to be my kinetic energy initial of whom? Of project. One project. Two project. Target. No one? Body one, body two, one, and say, hey, target steady. So, what is the question? Is that clear? Unfortunately, my lecture is okay. I have a second lecture. I have a second lecture. I subject पर concentrate करा, मैं interesting subject, थोड़ा सा अगला लूँ, कौन से? Okay, what will be this? Kinetic energy, fine. चलो, we will take a speed. Therefore, change in kinetic energy, दिया ना? Of projectile, बोला, दिया ना? Kinetic energy final, minus or initial. Minus 5. We initial minus 5 will get the because projectile is transferring its energy to the target. So what it will become? Delta. That's the change of time delta k. That is all. Delta k. Just the name under this. No problem. That is just the name under this. Potential is here u more open. And total is p more. Okay? So ki minus k. That will be 5. Ki. I minus m. That will be kya kya half m1 u1 square minus half m1 u1 square. Right? How much it becomes? Delta ke or delta ke. So, maybe half m1 into u1 square. Okay. You write this down. Everything. It's very simple. Now, you might have heard one term in your unit dimension. Unit dimension मते तुम्ही relative error काढली delta x upon x बरोबर ते जब ना percentage error काढली की थी delta x upon x into 100 percent okay so the factor delta x upon x okay that will be called as a fraction okay change upon initial okay so like that we can calculate the kinetic energy also fractional change in kinetic कसा काढणार होता therefore therefore, fractional change in kinetic energy. Is it delta k upon k? What is delta k? Half m1 u1 square minus v1 square divided by what is k? K initial. Is it what the k I am? Is something. What was there? K initial half m1 u1 square. Yes or no? Yes. Is that clear? M1 half half will get cancelled. U1 square will remain. So can I write? Let me check. So you, it will be u1 square minus v1 square. No, v1 square upon u1 square. So what will be delta k upon kr? Of course, u1 square upon u1 square. Kya ra? 1 minus v1 square upon u1 square. So can I write v1 upon u1 bracket square? Okay? This is VIMP. Right? as you go for competitives, this type of formula you must be ready. Okay? So half of your study work is already done in the school. Means we both are studying. Okay? But it means I am showing you on the board, you are writing down in your notebook. It means that at this time there is a gain in your knowledge. And hope you will get practice of that. Some formula, those which are giving you, which I am giving you, that you will keep in mind. Simple formula. Adhe karan tumhala example ko vichara nahi hai how it is coming. No, they will know that you already did that and you got this equation. Now they will only check whether you are knowing this or not and you are able to apply this or not. Okay, samajh sakle na? So that was one of the four. Okay, now yesterday I gave you one formula for V1. Do you have that formula? Okay. So let me first give you some time to you people also to write this. I will rub this. This will be here only. Now one of you will give me the formula for V1. What is the formula for V1? I think it is M1 minus M2 upon M1 plus M2 into U1 plus 2 M2 upon M1 plus M2 into U1. Okay, so now V1 is M1 minus M2 upon M1 plus M2 into U1 plus it is 2 M2 U2 and M2 U2 सांगितलं बघ कसं करायचं 2 M2 U2 upon M. Okay, now we have to put our condition. ज्या कंडिशन आपण टाकली, ओके, आता कंडिशन कुठली टाका? U2 ला 0 करा, म्हणजे कुठली केस झाली? आता बोलणार ना मला टार्गेट इज ऍट रेस. ओके, सो म्हणजे आधी मी काय केलं बघा, पहिली कॅलिब्रेशन काढून घेतली, त्याच्यामध्ये काय केलं? आय हॅव टेकन बोथ ऑफ देम हॅव्हिंग सेम मास. नो नो नो, आय हॅव नॉट टेकन सेम मास, जस्ट आय हॅव टेकन द कॅलिब्रेशन. काही केलं नाही, त्याच्यामध्ये काय केलं? फक्त फ्रॅक्शन चेंज करणार हे सॉल्व. आणि हे कोणासाठी काढले मी? हे कोणासाठी काढले? हे महत्वाचं आहे. इसके लिए बेटा, इसका है आणि प्रोजेक्टर का निकाल है. मतलब क्या हो जाएगा बेटा, जितना प्रोजेक्ट है लूज करेगा उतना फॉर्म गेन करेगा, टारगेट गेन करेगा. अरे गेटिंग पे पॉइंट दो बच्चे नहीं कर ली, गेटिंग पे पॉइंट अरे टारगेट अपना रेस्ट ला इधर भी कह देना फॉर टारगेट. ये समझ रहे हैं ना? अरे कंफर्टेबल, थोड़ा कॉन्सेंट्रेट कर. ओके, इधर टारगेट फॉर टारगेट एट रेस्ट U2 की जोड़ा 0 होना, सो पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ U2 टू बी 0. So how much you will get? M1 minus M2 upon M1 plus M2 into U1. बराबर? P value अपने H1 पर क्या मुझे? V1 upon U1 the square. Okay? So V1 will become, समझ रहा सही ना? V1 will become half. बोला M1 minus M2 upon M1 plus M2 into U1. ज़्यादा simple value. Putting this value, okay? Therefore में कॉलेज एजुकेशन सम डेल्टा के अपॉन के कितने ना होगा डायरेक्ट 1 माइनस v1 v1 बेटा है u1 u1 विल गेट कैंसिल अरे सो 1 माइनस m1 माइनस m2 अपॉन m1 प्लस m2 ब्रैकेट स्क्वायर अरे सो. ओके, आता याला सिंपलीफाई करू शकता. ओके, सिंपलीफिकेशन स्टेप मी तुम्हाला करून देतो डायरेक्ट, तुमचा वेळ झाला. ओके, so it will come 4 m1 m2 upon m1 plus m2 like this. You can do that. A square kela, a square minus 2ab plus b square, that's a 1 square kela, phir alag se chhipa, then you will rearrange, after that you will get. So after that you know, after that formula pe to pan nahi ye then chale 4 m1 m2 upon m1 minus m2 bracket square plus 4 m1. okay, so everyone look, okay, चालतं आता मी इथे का नाही थांबलो व्हाय आय एम नॉट स्टॉप हियर देयर इज अ रीझन सी डू यू नो राइट नाउ व्हाट इज द मास ऑफ टार्गेटेड व्हाट इज द मास ऑफ प्रोजेक्टेड नो इफ दे आर इक्वल व्हाट विल हैपन ओके इक्वेशन मध्ये बघून सांगा ना 1 minus 0 in the delta k upon k is 1 ala. 1 means 100% yes or no. Alaga. Yesterday we have seen na complete transfer of velocity from one to another. Means yani aapki kinetic energy sabhi dili ka. So the factor will come 1. So when the fractional change will become 1, it is your 100% exchange. Getting my point? But we will not get always m1 is equal to m2. Sometimes m1 will be greater than m2, sometimes m2 will be greater than m1. So in which factor we are interested? m1 upon m2. So either there are perfectly m1 upon m2 will be. So we are getting one more formula. Okay? So fokta tumhala shikun ghenyasathi aahe. Directly mi je tumhala formula denar aahe. Tevade tumhala baghayche. Getting my point? Tevade lakshat thevayche. Aapalyala kutla formula use karayche. Logic you have to use and then you have to operate on that formula. You will get your reason. Understood? What does you get it to me? Okay. So, delta k upon k will become 4 m1 m2 upon. I think it's a little critical of this. It's okay. Can I use this? It's okay. What is that? Note you here. No. Note, greater the difference between the masses, greater the difference between the masses, कोणाची projectile and target ते सांगायची गरज नाही. कमीत कमी बोलतो. Greater the difference between the masses, काय होणार? Lesser will be kinetic energy.
Next,
completely transferred to the target. Now we have to solve for more 3 for. How many? 3 for. Atta baga is 1 second occupation delay. They will not give you in the problem. You have to use this and solve the problem. Not like that. Till 11:10 we were doing that. I know that. That's tomorrow occasion. You have to find what is given. Just the target for mandar nahi. Door body jada. Ekala steady mandi. Kya apna samjhe? Consider that we say target. Target is steady. That is U2 is equal to 0. And mass vegare. So to be confused, sir, mass is different. Then what to do? So for that sake, again we will get the formula for stationary target. Kutle formula kyaise? Velocity, kinetic energy, and aapne position kutle perfectly PS. So we must know one more thing. Kinetic energy sari, velocity sari. Azu kya pahe? Azu ek sangite ra. Linear moment. So momentum of the target, momentum of the velocity of the target, and transfer of kinetic. Getting the point? So write down the heading: velocity, momentum, and kinetic energy of stationary target. I hope you have written this. Chale raha na? Now I'll read the speed. Velocity, comma, momentum and kinetic energy of stationary target. Stationary target will be given to me. Of course, M2 is equal to 0. Oh, sorry, U2 is equal to U B will be equal to. Okay, number one velocity. V1 and U2 got up. Atta new lag over. Tumke daya na V1 ki V1 ki diye, V1 ki diye. V1 ho, V2 got up. Target set kar. V2. M2 minus M1 upon M1 plus M2 into. Ola ola. U2 plus 2 m1 u1 upon m1 plus m2. What is u2? 0. So what will do? U2 will be 0. So first part of my equation will become 0. Second number na? V2 bada. Check v2. The equation with the u2 equal to 0. Okay? Everybody got the idea? Karun daga. And are you getting v2 is equal to Two M1 U1 upon M1 plus M2 ratio by na M1 upon M2 sorry sir. I'm having M1. So how to get the ratio? Simple. Divide both numerator and denominator by M2. That's why M1. M2 make it the ratio. No need to get that. So 2M1 U1 upon M1 divided by M1 plus M2 upon M1. What about M1 will be cancelled? Kela split kela M1 upon M1 1, M2 upon M1, M2 upon M1. Are you sure? So shall I write directly V2 is equal to 2U1 upon 1 plus M2 upon 1. Yes, sir. There you go. Now consider this M2 upon M1 to be the N ratio. Okay? target, sorry, projectile is double of target. So m1 is equal to 2m2. So m2 upon m1 ratio 1. So you will get particularly value of n. Array as well. Now simple, let's simple the formula. So let n is equal to m2 upon m1. Therefore, what do we get? V2 is equal to simple the formula. 2u1 upon 1 plus n. Array as well. What the idea? Some other second. This is VIM. Velocity of target. Momentum कांडर है, momentum of target, so far. कैसे करना? V2 क्या है बता? V2 V what? Momentum से formula क्या है? V2 will be m2 V2, so multiply m2 by V2. The value of momentum of the race one. Second right, you do. I will just think. Second, momentum of target. V2 is equal to M2, sorry, V2.
Thank you.
रख दिया, हो गया, कितना आया? Yes, ये लगा, फर्क? Shall I rub this? Write down. Kinetic energy of target. Call it as K2. K2 is equal to half M2 V2 square, that is equal to half M2 V2 की दिया था 2 M2 sorry 2 U1 ना 2 U1 upon bracket square so my K2 will become half M2 into 4 U1 square upon 1 plus N okay bracket square Last one we will go for head of collision only, perfectly not head of collision, perfectly elastic but not head of oblique collision. Okay, so after finishing we will go for okay. I'll not waste my time in revising all you are doing. Okay, so now put the heading perfectly elastic oblique collision. Moving with U1, this is N2 moving with U2. The idea is that after collision, what will happen? This is before collision. Suppose collisions are there. After collision, what will happen? It will be called after collision. M1 is moving. M1 is moving, say, with velocity V1. Making angle theta with the horizontal. Okay. In horizontal proportion. And say M2 is moving with velocity V2. Making angle phi. Okay. Got the idea? Now see, before collision there is no problem. Before collision there is no problem. M1 E1 plus M2 U2. But now it is having both along X and along Y. Are you getting my point? See. What will be the velocity? U1, that will be U1 into I cap plus 0 J cap raise or move. Y cap moves are raise. U2, same, U2 into I cap plus 0 J cap. So, while writing the momentum conservation, I have to write how many equations? Two equations, raise or horizontal component and vertical component. Okay, so what is the horizontal component before collision? Say it is. So, number 1, what is right? M1 U1 plus M2 U2 is equal to horizontal component means along X. Okay, now see, this is V1 and this is theta. So, this will become V1 cos theta. This will become V1 sin. Now here. Here it is V2 and this is phi. Okay? So it will be V2 cos phi and this will be V2 sin phi. But it will be minus down. Na? So I can show that minus V2 sin. Understood? So shall I write over here? X component. What is the X component? V1 cos phi. Theta plus V2 cos phi. Okay, write down there V1 cos theta plus V2 cos phi. Getting the idea? This is along X. Will you write along Y? But can you along Y, what will happen? What will be LHS? Patkar bola. LHS. 0, 0, 0. 0 is equal. Samadha? There is no motion along Y direction initially. Y la moves on that way. So there is a 0 motion. 0 velocity. So momentum along Y is 0. Okay? 0 equal. Now tell me about then momentum. M2, sorry, M1 V1 sin theta, correct, minus M2 V2 sin phi, V1, are correct now, sin theta, minus M2 V2 sin phi, generally. Okay? Are yes sir? Hello, Kailan. M1 V1 sin theta is equal to M2 V2 sin. simple. What is m1 u1 plus m2 u2? What is m1 u1 plus m2 u2? X component of the momentum before collision. What is 0? Other secret something. Y component of the momentum before collision. What is this? V1 cos theta plus V2 cos phi? X component of momentum after collision. And what is this? Y component of the momentum after collision. Okay. So P, if P is the momentum before collision, I can write Px into I cap plus Py into J cap. Yes? And P dash is the final momentum. Then how we can write P dash X into I cap plus P dash X, P dash Y into J cap. But you will not get it understood. Now here you are getting the form of equations, which are very necessary for us. Right? Now we will do only one thing. Simple job karte hai. Kya karega? Isko ekdam simple bana lega. प्रॉब्लम क्या आएगा बेटा आपको? प्रॉब्लम लगातार बहुत साल से पूछा है, मतलब वो पूछा है सेम मास का, इसलिए आपने भी सेम मास के लिए उसको डिराइव किया, सब रूप में होगा. सेम मास के लिए क्या होगा? m1 इक्वल टू m2. अरे सो राइट डाउन. चलो अब दिस ओके, यू आल्सो राइट डाउन, देन आई विल गो फॉर नेक्स्ट. ओके थैंक यू. हां, व्हाट विल बी आवर केस? m1 इक्वल टू m2. If m1 is equal to m2, what I can write? For this to be equation number 1 and this to be equation number 2, and get m1 is equal to m2 is equal to say m. m will get cancelled and get u1 plus u2 is equal to v1 cos theta plus v2 cos phi. हाँ, मतलब क्या करें सर? माइक को मारो. टारगेट इज एड्रेस. समझ तो मारो, ठीक समझने का क्या करते हैं सर? अरे सर, ठीक समझते ना, एक निकाल के बोला मैंने, कारण क्या था? मतलब एक बार एक बदल कर, सो आई गॉट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ u1 एंड u2. अब u2 जीरो सर, इन द टारगेट इज एड्रेस. Implies, u2 will be 0. Are you sure? I have not made any statement about u1 and u2. Asar ye target discover manantar se transfer ke liye nahi. Because now they are being oblique. So you cannot say that projectile will completely transfer its energy. No, not like that. Getting my point? So this is the case of striking the point with the striker so that it will go in that direction. Striker काम तो कर रही है, मुझे तो ना सुना जाता है striker करूँ बोला कैरम में, जब तुम्हीं हाँ जब तुम्हीं strike किया, if the point is going in that pocket, say striker may go some angle, exact same उसको getting the point. Why it is not same? अब तेरा बगैर से नहीं चलते, sound common sense knowledge. Striker has its own weight, own mass. It is never equal to mass of the point. Array sir, you can weigh it. There is some difference. So if u2 is equal to 0, then u1 will become v1 cos theta plus v2 cos phi. Array sir. And second no problem. Second same as na? Why? There is no u2, only m karo daga. M karo daga, common ya, it will be 0 na. So, 0 is equal to bola. You only tell me. V1 sin theta minus Okay. Now the step next to this, I will only show you on the board. You don't write it. हाँ तुम्हारा पाइज़े तो लियूंगे। मैंने नोटबुक में जब नोटबुक लिया, तुम्हारा पाइज़े तो लियूंगे। बगा मत कौन से? Okay. How many of you know the formula for sin a plus minus b, cos a plus minus b? Raise your hands. Let me see. Sin a plus b. Okay. So, cos a plus b. What is the formula for sin a plus b? Tell me better. Plus half, plus minus, cos a sin. Any cos of formula again? Minus plus sin. Any degree sin of plus sin. The degree plus sin. Minus is in minus. But for cos, it will be, if it is plus, then it will be minus. If it is minus, then it will be plus. And what is the difference? Sin is in the sin and cos, sin cos cos sin. Cos is in the cos sin. Okay. So those who are not knowing, for them, I will write the formula on the board, for a point, and then we go for next. Sin A plus minus B. What is that? Sin A cos B plus minus cos A sin B. Using this, you can do multiples of angles. Allied angle geometry is called. Okay? Then, cos A plus minus B is equal to cos A cos B minus plus sin A sin. Those are going, no need to write. Now, square and add the equations. Equation number 3 and equation number 4. Okay? Forever away to them. Okay? Are ready? Are they in the class? Sleeping? Or the sleeping number? Yes. Are you sleeping? Yes, sir. Of course. Okay. So, what I will write? Squaring and adding. Padha do. Chalo. Tumhi kela ke chale maar jao. 3 and 4. Padha liye? Ha. U1 square is equal to V1 cos theta by 10 plus V2 cos phi. Right it square. So, it will be V1 square cos square theta plus V2 square cos square phi plus 2V1 V2 cos theta cos phi raise to 0 is equal to bola V1 square sin square theta plus V2 square sin square phi minus 2V1 V2 sin theta sin phi. Add then direct add to raise houses. Okay, U1 square plus 0, U1 plus V1 square, Magani, into cos square plus sin square, 1, Lala, plus V2 square, cos square plus sin square, 1, Ata plus, Ata kai kai, plus 2V1 V2, okay, cos theta cos phi minus sin theta sin phi. This is my cos theta plus phi. Hai na? Therefore, U1 square is equal to V1 square plus V2 square plus 2V1 V2 cos theta plus theta plus phi. Okay? So, can you get the idea? Which vector addition I am using over here? Formula for vector addition. If I consider U1, direction of U1 to be the resultant, then it will be taken from V1 and V2. Yes, sir. Okay. So it is like that. This is my U1, this is my V1, and this is my V2. This is theta, this is phi. Okay. So can I write vector U1 is equal to how much? A21 plus A22?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And then, one more special case from this. More special case, that is, if U1 square is equal to V1 square plus V2 square. What it means? Tell you what? This will become 0. And when this will become 0?
90.
What 90? Plus 5 will be 5. Okay? That also we have to write. Okay? It is much more lazy, I know that. But if you take it with interest, you will come to know what is it. Till now, you have understood everything? Is there a doubt? Any query? So today I will increase my speed. It's like, I will not go very fast. Now see, the kinetic energy conservation. Okay? What is the kinetic energy conservation? Okay. M1 U1 square plus M2 U2 square. Half. Karun it. Manamane karun it. Okay. U2 ki diya 0. Okay. Mass same. Baka, karay di karun. No need to do. Mass is same. So M will get cancel. Half will get cancel. What is remaining? V1 square plus U1 square. U1 square plus U2 square is equal to V1 square plus V2 square. Out of that U2 is 0. What is U2 square? 0. Okay. So, from kinetic energy conservation, taking U2 is equal to 0 and M1 is equal to M2 is equal to M. Take it up. Five are now. Half M1 square plus half M2 square is equal to half M1 square plus half M2 square. Half M will get cancelled, U2 square will be 0 and get U1 square is equal to V1 square plus V2 square. Yes or no? But what is the value of U1 square? I am getting V1 square plus 2, V2 square plus 2V1 into cos theta plus 1. But I am getting U1 square is equal to V1 square plus V2 square. So can I say that? Therefore, we can say what? 2v1 v2 cos theta plus 5 is equal to 0. Cos for the 0 though, pi by 2 love. So it implies theta plus 5 2. Okay? This is a very important information you will be required to use when it's a problem. Okay? That was all about the perfectly elastic. Okay. So you may just check your notebook. What I have taught from starting all type of collisions is first only elastic collision. So this all for me you have to keep in mind. How you will keep in mind that I know? Don't know. Just by doing practice, you will be able to keep in mind. Okay? And this comes with a lot of practice. I will give you some DVDs. You will try to solve that. How much time is remaining? Half an hour. I'll go there and check. After completing this, write the heading head on inelastic prism. Now the prism will not be elastic, inelastic. Okay? But head on. Okay? That's what I said. Head on inelastic. I will not do all the formulations. Sri Aplika, what is the important formula? E. Correct? Now E will help you a lot. E is equal to V2 minus V1 upon U1 minus U2. Correct, sir. And for inelastic collision, what it is there? 0 less than E less than 1. And we can write V2 minus V1 is equal to E into U1 minus U2. That's all. Okay. That's all. Write the value. Write the formula. Okay. The problem is V1 will be the value. But I will give it. V1 V2 pilot love. M1 minus M2 upon M1 plus M2 into V1 U1 plus that same. But here the tact is that, technique is that. I will not give you directly. I will give you in the form of E or 1 plus. Okay? That one. Call this as equation number 1. Operate momentum conservation. Momentum will be conserved, but kinetic energy will not get conserved. Okay? So before going to that, let me check. Okay? In each type of collision, of course, there will be the conservation of momentum. Okay? But if it is perfectly rest, then with the momentum, kinetic energy will also get conserved. That is why if one is coming at rest and another is getting the same velocity, very sir. So that kinetic energy, so for perfectly elastic collision, you can say that how much is the kinetic energy lost by the projectile? That must be the kinetic energy gained by target. For which collision? Perfectly elastic. But here, it is not. It is not that. Some of the energy get lost. Okay? So, we will operate only the momentum conservation. Okay? Is that clear? Can we go further? So, what is momentum conservation? Tell me M1 U1 plus M2 U2 is equal to M1 V1 plus M2 PD. That is my equation number second. Now you have to solve for equation number 1 and 2. Okay? Solving equations 1 and 2, don't solve that. I do have already for me solving that. So there is no problem. Only lachatio doesn't take us. Okay? It is same like prior. Okay? So V1 will be half. Solving 1 and 2 we will get V1 is equal to M1 minus EM2. We may write directly. So our type will be utilized upon M1 plus M2 into U1 plus 1 plus E into M2 upon M1 plus M2 into U. Okay? V2 read out to me? Yes. V2? Tell me the formula for V2. M2 minus E M1 upon M1 plus M2 into U2 plus 1 plus E into M1 upon M1 plus M2 into U1. That's all. Very nice. M2 minus E M1 upon M1 plus M2 into U2 plus 1 plus E M1 upon. Yes, sir. 1 plus E R1. We can operate many cases in that. If they are having same mass, then M1 is equal to M2. Correct? So M1, M2, M will get common power. M power in R, M1 plus M2 is 2M. So M will get cancel. 1 minus E upon 2 into U1. So 1 minus E into U1 upon 2 plus. Now suppose target steady SL. U2 will become 0. Getting a point? Here also. Getting my idea? So in this way we will go on doing the formulas. I know that today of course I will not go in the detail of that. From tomorrow I will be giving you all the formulations. And tomorrow we will complete inelastic collision and we will go for perfectly inelastic collision. That is the bullet and the box. Okay? So tomorrow this teaching of this collision will get finished. There are some important points like linear impulse, rocket propulsion, that I would take. Okay, then we'll complete. Then we'll go for solving the problems, and then we'll go for center of mass. Center of mass solve kele sir, nine. Center of mass solve kele C O M. Kele complete jala. Then we have to go for rotational motion. Correct? No? T. After center of mass, this was about to come. Okay. So, what is the solution? That's why I am not able to get actually what is that. That is not a problem. Okay. So, once you check it, whether you have completed everything, and I will go for checking your DPT because that is important. Okay. So please open your DPT, let me check everything you have done off.
तुम्हाला नेक्स्ट डीपीपी देणार. नेक्स्ट डीपीपी इज ऑफ कायनेमॅटिक्स, मीन्स ऑल मोशन इन वन डायमेन्शन, टू डायमेन्शन, लाइक प्रोजेक्टाइल, सर्क्युलर, एव्हरीथिंग, वर्टिकल सर्क्युलर मोशन, नॉन युनिफॉर्म, युनिफॉर्म. सो हे लवकर क्लिअर कर. वेक्टर्स काय आहे त्याच्यात? हॅव यू कम्प्लीट वेक्टर्स? वाय यू आर नॉट कम्प्लीटेड? हां, आय हॅव गिव्हन द डेडलाईन. व्हॉट इज द डेडलाईन? फ्रायडे. सो ॲटलीस्ट बेसिक मॅथ्स तरी झाले का? डाऊट काय नाही. ठीक आहे, तुम्हाला येण्यास जमलं ना तुला. दॅट वी विल डू इन मॅथ्स. आपल्याकडे आपण हा प्रोसेस वी मस्ट नो. सो इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू सिम्प्लिफाय इट फर्दर, इट्स ओके, लीव इट वर देअर. ओनली चेक वेदर आय एम करेक्ट इन दोज स्टेप्स. दॅट्स ऑल. So, you have to, so you also open your sheet and at least basic maths must be complete, okay? So, for vectors, you are provided with how many questions? I think. For vectors, हा फंक्शन नाही सोडवलं तरी चालेल. मध्ये झालं ना फंक्शन. ओके, द प्रॉब्लेम्स विच आर बेस्ड ऑन वेक्टर्स यू मे कम्प्लीट, है ना. फर्स्ट थिंग टुडे यू डू दॅट, टुडे टुमॉरो डे आफ्टर टुमॉरो. ओके, यू टेक युअर टाइम, नो प्रॉब्लेम. You are also new?
Not able to read your. So today I will take the round of introduction. What about now or something?
My name is Om.
So what?
Om.
Sir, from where?
80 degrees.
80.
My name is Srinath.
Srinath.
Difficult, the most difficult ever task, because without practice it is not advisable to directly solve the problem. So next lecture I will give you say DPP of especially for collision, and we'll try to solve the problems on collision. Okay, today I will give you the idea for one of the basic problem for the collision. Okay, are ready for that? And about this DPP on Friday, today is Wednesday. Oh, Thursday, Friday. Day after tomorrow I will check you. So till this we have seen the perfect elastic collision. So regardless of now anything matters, you have to just solve some problems. Mass of 3 kg, say ball of 1 kg, not 3 kg. Now that prior problem I have taken, now that all we will try to calculate. Okay, it is hitting with the stationary ball. Okay, having angle say 45 degree. Okay. And suppose it is initially having the velocity 20 meter per second. Okay, collision is elastic, perfect elastic collision. Okay, so how many things you can calculate from this? Okay, okay. Now you decide what you want to tell, what is given. Okay, you see the problem, I have taught you all the things. Okay, so from that you change which things are given, what you have to take zero, what will be there, many things are there. And mass are give to the case. Okay. So first, ball is stationary. Are you sure? The kind of U2 is given 0. Also, make the Sankita na problem. If you bole na ba, they will not delay. It is a case of M1 very very less than. Are you sure? Target is heavy and projectile is light. So I told na nano. Now is traveling, one container is standing, and nano is hitting strike on the container. We see them now. So try to operate that. No need to do that. Directly also we can do. So this angle is also say 45 degree. Okay. Okay. Or you try to get this angle. Don't take it as a problem, just look at the problem and try to get the idea what we can tell. Okay, so the formula will be observed, then you will get the idea how we are actually solving the problems. Okay, तुम्हाला दिले ना m1 greater than sorry m1 greater than less than दिले ना I think दिले त्याच्यामध्ये काय येतं हां u2 0 ना v1 किती आहे हां 2 u2 minus u1 u2 किती आहे आपल्याकडे 0 आहे किती येणार v1 is equal to minus what we did. This is U1. Ah, this is V1. Okay. What will do? Of course, it will get reflected. So this angle will also be 45. Okay. So what will be total momentum? So for that, sir, let's sum it up. So into zero, we have, and V1 is equal to minus Q1. All right. It is going in that way. It is going in this. If I simple get something, pay last get something, sir. Ball is coming like this. Okay. After bouncing. Okay. सिंपल मध्ये आला v1 = -u इथे फक्त काय होणार आहे कॉम्पोनेंट्स आपण ना cos cos 45 ओके सो ट्राय टू डू दिस ओके व्हाट फाइंडिंग टोटल फाइनल नॉट टोटल फाइनल तुम्हाला आहे कंप्लीट द प्रॉब्लेम्स ओके आज मी काही प्रॉब्लेम पाहिले I will take some problems and make that sheet and provide it. You go on solve. Okay? So for tomorrow we will go for inelastic collision and perfectly inelastic collision. So. Now tell me. Is there any point in your prior 4-5 months you learned and that point you are expecting from me? Sorry, I am not sagana common sangasaka hai na kinetics madhe projectile madhe okay ase tha a common point I will explain you on the board okay for you people also If any common point is there, sir, you are not understood. I will explain the concept. So till December end, I will give you the time span. You try to overcome the queries, difficulties, whatever you are getting. And till December, I expect from you that you will be completing unit dimension, vector, kinematics, or part two. All projectile, circular, WP and COM and with this okay and I think on 13 your exam is there, na? So what are the topics for exam? Not in given, we will give you soon, okay? So I expect in upcoming exam for 13 you will have to score well, okay? Be serious, do a lot of practice. Whatever you are not knowing, not understanding, ask to me, there is no problem. But I will expect good score from you. Okay? Is that clear to everybody?
Yes.
So seriously, do your task, do your studies. No problem. So clear. सो आता नोटबुक मध्ये जरा लिहून दिले त्याचे पॉइंट बघा कुठले कुठले केस मी आता कशी वापरली पटकन तुम्हाला केस समजली ओके राईट नाऊ यू आर नॉट कॉन्फिडंट बिकॉज देर इज नो क्वेश्चन इन फ्रंट ऑफ दॅट्स वन्स यू विल गेट क्वेश्चन देन यू विल गो ऑन इन हा दॅट इज अ ग्रेट इंटरेस्टिंग ओके मला सांगायला पास करायला पास प्रॉब्लेम सॉल्व पास Soon I will give you this. Bye.